Some people are born more fortunate than others. Such was the case with me. But as a child, I was convinced of quite the opposite. What little girl does not dream of growing up as a princess? But some palaces are not at all what you'd think. Even a palace can be a prison. Mama never explained why she would have someone taste my food, why I couldn't attend school with other children or read popular books. When my father died, Mama and her advisor, Sir John Conroy, created rules. He said they were for my protection, and he called it the Kensington system. I could not sleep in a room without Mama, or even walk downstairs without holding the hand of an adult. I learned the reason for all this when I was 11. My Uncle William was the King of England, yet he and his three brothers could boast only one living child. And that was me. Sir John's dream was that the king would die and there would be a regency where my mother would rule England and he would rule my mother. So I began to dream of the day when my life would change and I might be free. And I prayed for the strength to meet my destiny.
I will be good.
Of the modern composers, I suppose Vincenzo Bellini is my favorite.
What a coincidence. So is mine. Oh, which of his operas do you enjoy most? No, wait, let me guess. I Puritani?
As a matter of fact, yes.
I used to like it too. Now I prefer Norma.
Dashy! Go fetch it! Fetch it, Dash!
Have I offended you in some way?
No.
And Schubert. I like Schubert. I think perhaps you don't, but I do.
I don't mind Schubert.
Good.
Her Majesty the Queen.
Sure, this is wise.
It's been quite a day. Are you tired?
Oh, no. Well, not really. It's just... Well, I'm stronger than I look. How much longer are you in London?
Only until Friday. Then home via Brussels. Uncle Leopold must have his report.
Oh, dear. I have a quadrille with the Prince of Prussia next. My poor little toes. I feel sorry for them already.